are food policies?
Food policies are a set of policies at a global and national scale that policymakers have learned to appreciate the supply-demand economic ideology and which triggered new interest in the availability of and access to food. Due to the historical events in 1972 to 1974, the world food crisis.
So, what is the point of having such food policies?
You will eventually find out when you learn more about it.
Okay, let's go then. The purpose of having food policies is to have food security. What is food security? There are several definitions to it, but in general, food security exists when the country is able to provide the dietary needs and food preferences for an active and healthy life at all times. So what can food policy actually do? Each country seeks to have food security, but how does food policies help achieve that national interest? In developed or developing countries, there are factors to consider such as diseases from food, junk food, and obesity, etc. Food policies can intervene and take public action if there is market failure, under provision of public goods and universal access and equality concerns. Because food policies help the nation live a better and healthier life with limits on the consumption of certain unhealthy or fat-making food, this triggers for a successful government regulation towards the nation's people. If the government cannot solve a problem such as obesity rates, it would mean that their social, political, and economical status is bad. So, why is there different prices for the same type of food? Food prices can be affected by different factors, such as demand of food, seasonal changes, etc. But places such as Hong Kong where food is expensive, prices are usually affected due to the price of land. Since Hong Kong is the top 10 places in the world where land prices are considered very high, food prices are also high. The most notable place in Hong Kong where prices are at the roof is at Sai Kung. In addition, you probably think that the Tuen Mun Yuen Long side of Hong Kong is the cheapest because it is closer to China borders. But this is not the case, because Hong Kong does not necessarily depend on China too much on import.
After having a quick lesson of food policies, do you think we should buy local or international food products?
I think they both have their own benefits. Buying local food products are cheap and mostly fresh, as it is only transferred within the city, whereas buying international food products generally provide a better quality.
Yep, you are correct. Did you know some governments place laws to their citizens to only permit them to buy local food products to encourage such industries?
Yeah, I heard that there was a movement called Eat Local Challenge, where they were only allowed to buy food products within 500 kilometers of their radius. This movement creates less fuel consumption and the encouragement of local industries.
In America, officials have created food policies to help fight against obesity. They use reducing strategies and increase accessibility to healthy, good quality food. For example, in Seattle, the officials improve access to healthy food and promoting of eating healthy. In New York City, the people are encouraged to buy local brands.
From all this information, I'm still not sure to buy more of local or international food products.
No worries, let's go ask some people.
I go to the grocery store probably at least 2 times a day.
Buy a lot of fruit and a lot of veggies, so because we consume a lot of that.
What do I buy? A lots of stuff. What if you can eat and enjoy eating? Vegetable, meat, canned goods, drinks, yeah, a variety of things.
We probably spend between $600 and $800 a week on groceries.
$200 or $300.
I buy both, whichever is cheaper.
Having grew up overseas for a big part of my life, I do enjoy some things from overseas. But the everyday thing, most of them are just local.
I think there are a couple of reasons. Number one, as products get older on the shelf, like especially perishable products like milk, cheeses, meat, sometimes they'll reduce the price after a certain number of days so that it's cheaper because they still want people to buy it rather than them having to throw it away if it passes the expiry date. So that's one reason for differences in price.
I would assume that the difference in price has a lot to do with things being imported. If it's going to be imported, it's going to cost more. So that would be the reason for the difference in price.
There are still supporters for both kinds of food products.
Yeah. Price is a big issue that affects the choices for the citizens.
Well, why is there such a big difference in prices, although it is the same product?
The reason for this is due to various factors. Firstly, the location the product comes from. If the product is local, the transfer of the product is only within the city, and the price will stay low. If it's from a foreign country, it might have to be shipped, thus leading to the increase in price of the product to maintain profit. Secondly, the quality of the product. Foreign products generally have a better quality due to their environment. Through the difference in quality of the products, the prices can be further raised. After all this I've taught you, can you now answer why there are food policies?
Of course, food policies are designed to influence the operation of food and the agriculture systems. Food policies determine what kind of food consumers have access to, information available pertaining to the place of origin, and rules and regulations that influence many aspects of farming. Through food policies, the citizens' health can also be protected. After all this information, I think food products should be bought both locally and internationally.
Hey, we have to go!